Hello students, welcome to today's computer practical class. And today we are going to make few programs based on input statement. About input statement, we have already discussed in previous video, and those who have not seen the previous video, they can get the link from the description box. So let's start. First program is, write a program in QBasic format to print the total amount paid to the shopkeeper for purchasing the following items: number of exercise books 10, number of brown paper rolls 4. So a customer has purchased 10 exercise books and 4 brown paper rolls, but price of these have not mentioned in the program. So we have to input the price of exercise book as well as paper roll. Fine. So let's start. So first CLS to clear the screen. Now we will use input statement to enter price of one exercise book. So this is a syntax. Now we can take any variable name. I am taking here price of book PB. Fine. Now what we have to input? Enter price of one paper roll. Enter price of one paper roll, and variable for this I am taking PR. Fine. So we have taken the prices PB and PR. Now already given number of books 10 and number of rolls, how much was given? Let's see, 10 and 4. So it's already given 10 and 4. Here the let statement is not mandatory, it is optional. So either you can write or you can remove it, it doesn't matter. Fine. Let statement is, I hope you remember, let statement is used to assign the value into a variable. Now we need to find total amount to be paid. So I am taking variable TA. So how will you calculate total amount? Number of books into price of books. Number of books into price of books plus number of rolls into, for into we will use the asterisk sign, and B into PR. Fine. Now we need to display it, and to display which statement we use? Print statement. Print total amount to be paid TA, total amount to be paid TA, then to end the program we will use end. I hope it is clear. Price of one book and price of one roll we have taken from the user, then number of books, number of rolls already given, then we calculated by using this formula, NB into PB plus NR into PR, and then we have displayed it. So let's see, shift F5, we will run it. So first it will ask enter price of one exercise book. Let it be 100. Fine. Now it is asking paper roll 50. So 150 I have taken. Let's see 1200. How it comes? 100 into 10 plus 50 into 4. 15 to 4, 200, and that is 1000. So answer is correct. I hope it is clear. Okay. Now we will see the second program. I am not saving it. Now the second program. In an examination, 20% students failed in English and 30% failed in maths. Write a program to find the total number of students who failed in both the subjects. Taking the total number of students who failed in both the subjects in the class as input. Fine. This was repeated, that's why I am removing. Taking the total number of students who failed in both the subjects in the class as input. Fine. So 20% students failed in English and 30% students failed in maths. Now we don't know how many total number of students. So what we will use as an input? We will take input total number of students by using input statement. Fine. Then we will calculate the total number of students failed in English. And we will calculate the total number of students failed in math. Then we will add it. This way we will get total number of students failed in both the subjects. So let's start. CLS input. What shall I input? Enter the total number of students you can take any variable. I am taking TS, total number of students. Now we need to calculate number of failed students in English. Percentage is given 20%. So, I am taking a variable NFE, number of failed students in English. You can take any variable, fine, but it should be relevant, like NFE, number of failed students in English. 20/100, 20% of total number of students. So, total number of students here it is TS, fine. Now I am taking another variable, number of students failed in maths, 30/100 into TS, fine. Now we will calculate total number of students failed in both the subjects. So TSF, I have taken variable. Now I will add these two variables, NFE plus NFM. Fine. Now we are going to display it. Print total number of students failed in both the subjects. And the variable is TSF. And now we will close the program by using end. I hope it is clear. So first we will input total number of students. When we will run it, it will ask you enter the total number of students and then question mark. So then we will enter number of students, then it will calculate NFE and NFM. So let's run. Shift F5. Okay, number of students I am taking here 60. So it is showing total number of students failed in both the subjects 30. So let's calculate. Let's see whether our answer is correct or not. 20% of TS. How much it is? 20%. 20 by 100 into 60, isn't it? Then how much it will come? 12. Then 30% of 60? 18. 12 plus 18, 30. Answer is correct? Fine. Now we will see the next program. So what is our next program? Write a program in QBasic format to find the value of S in the given equation, taking the suitable value of UVAS input. This is the expression. S equals to, this is square. This I have typed in notepad, that's why I have written like this, because no superscript option is there. So it is V square minus U square divided by 2A. So this is our expression. So first we need to input these three variables. Very simple. So let's start. CLS input enter values of U, V and A. And the three variables U, V, A. Fine. Now we will calculate S. Now V square. Either you write V asterisk V or you can use the exponent symbol. I am taking here exponent V exponent 2, fine, V square minus U square, U exponent 2, fine. This I will put in bracket. Then slash. Slash 2a was there. So how will I write in QBasic? 2 asterisk a. Fine. So we will convert that mathematical expression into QBasic expression. This is your QBasic expression. Now we will print it. Print value of S. Value of S equals to, you can give the sign, and then S variable. Fine, then end. So let's run. Shift F5. So it will ask you three values. 5, I am taking as a U, then V, then A. I don't know the answer. So it comes minus 9. I hope it is correct because V square minus U square. Okay, fine. It will be negative because we have taken 4. Fine. So if you wish, you can run it again by taking the value of V greater than U. So let's see. Again I am running it. U I am taking small. V I am taking 5. V square minus U square. Now 2 I am taking this. Now it is positive 9. Fine. Because V should be greater. V square minus U square. I hope it is clear. Okay. Now we will make one last program. Let's see what is the program. You purchased a computer textbook and an Oxford dictionary. The shopkeeper allows 10% discount on textbook and 20% discount on the dictionary. Write a program to calculate the total discount and the amount to be paid to the shopkeeper, taking price of the books as input. So this is mentioned in this program. We need to take price of the books as input. If it is not mentioned, this is very obvious. In some program, it will not be mentioned. Fine. So it is very obvious that we need to take price of the books as input. Discounts are given. Fine. So let's start. CLS. So first we will input, enter price of computer book. You can take any variable. I have taken price of computer book PC. Fine. Input, enter price of Oxford dictionary. I am taking PD, price of dictionary. Then we will calculate the discount. So I am taking a variable DC. 10% discount is 10%. So 10/100, 10/100 asterisk, of which price. So we need to write PC. Discount on dictionary. How much percent it was? 20%. So 20/100 into price of dictionary PD. Fine. Then we will calculate total discount DC plus DD. Then, so what will be amount paid? Amount paid will be total price minus total discount. So total price, what will be total price? PC plus PD. PC plus PD. Either you calculate separately PC plus PD or directly you can write. Fine. PC plus PD minus total discount. Total discount is TD. Fine. Now we need to print both. Print total discount equals to what is TD. Print amount to be paid. Amount to be paid. What it is? AP. Fine. And then end. Fine. Now we will see. So first it is asking price of computer book. Let it be 150. Price of dictionary, let it be 350. So total discount, it is showing 85 and amount to be paid 415 after discount. I hope it is correct. Fine. So that's it. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.